Hello, this is Travis Sabin with Adobe Analytics Product Management, and today I want to walk you through some great additional features we've added to the Journey Optimizer reporting experience. So in addition to the new reports within Journey Optimizer, we've added some great new capabilities on top of the new reporting structure and style. So I'm going to walk you through four new capabilities that we've added to these reports. So if you open up any report and you see any given table or Journey Canvas viz, you can right click on a node in the Journey Canvases to create an audience, or you can right click on a column header, a row header, or a specific cell within a table to create an audience from that selection. So once you click create audience, the audience builder will pop up on your screen. Now, depending on your CJA entitlement, you will either see the full audience builder if you are a CJA customer, or if you're a non-CJA customer, you'll see a modified version of this build that's just a little bit more simplified. You simply give it a name, a description. If you're an AGO only customer, then you will be publishing a one-time audience, and you can see your audience criteria is automatically added here in the builder. You simply have to just give it a name, and then you can publish it, and it'll become available in the audience library for use for retargeting or downstream marketing events and activities. So that's the first one. That's audience publishing. That's really great. The next is the ability to create and insert simple metrics directly into the report. So here we have some of these standard metrics on this table. If I want to know the conversion rate between my enters and exits, I highlight these two column headers and then right click again. And in addition to the audience option, I now have an option to create a metric. You can only do two metrics. If you choose three, it will automatically drop the third or any more that you have beyond three and do the first two that you've selected. And similarly to the audience publisher, if you're a full CJA customer, you'll get the full calc metric builder. If you're an AGO only customer, you'll get a simplified version of this view where you can give it a name and a description. You can choose the formatting for it, and you can move around the ordering of these if you selected them in the wrong order, if you want to change how it is. And then you can choose from one of the four standard operators to do add, subtract, multiply, or divide. And then in this case, I've got it how I want. And then I hit apply. And so now it's immediately added right after the two metrics I highlighted before directly on the table. So now in this case, my data is pretty streamlined, so 100%, it's not that informative or interesting, but I've got it now directly added on the table, and I can now customize the rest of the table or any other tables that I have here in our reports with some of these simple metrics that you might want to create. So that's feature number two. And also, if you don't want to use it anymore or you want to get rid of it, you can click X. If you leave the report and then I come back, that metric will not persist. So they are one-time metric creations. They don't stay saved on the report. So if I open this back up, my table now should have just my exits and my enters instead of my conversion one. Yeah, you can see I've got enters and exits, but that metric I added is not included. So these don't persist. They're just for a one-time use for that specific ad hoc reporting that you're doing at the time. So that's a good call out to know. So that's number two. Number three is a new reporting experience we've added to every single report. So whether you're in campaigns, journeys, the overview report, subscription lists, anything like that, at the very bottom, you can either scroll all the way down or using the little table of contents here, you can scroll all the way to the bottom here to this exploratory analysis. The exploratory analysis, or what we're probably going to call the insight builder, is a way to ask your own questions. So we've got a lot of great curated content, but this might lead to more questions that you don't know because the data isn't displayed the way you would expect it to be. So here you can come and you can ask your own questions. So you can pick a dimension or a component type that describes kind of the behaviors of the things you're seeing, and a metric. So I want to know channel, and I want to know clicks by channel. So I add at least a dimension and metric. And when I do that, I automatically get a freeform table built with an accompanying visualization. Now I can add more metrics. I can add up to three if I want. So if I want to see people and I want to see sends, for example. I can add all three of those, and now I can see how they're performing against one another across my three channels and which ones better are performing best. And then I can also do a breakdown. So if I want to see channel broken down by, let's do day, for example. It'll automatically break down the top days for each of these different channels in terms of the values that we're seeing. So you can do some quick breakdowns and an in-depth analysis right here in the canvas. Now this isn't everything, and you can't do everything that you might be able to do in terms of real deep dive analysis. That's what customer journey analytics is for, but this gives you a way to ask some pretty simple basic questions and get some quick answers all here directly on the canvas. So that's exploratory analysis, or what will soon be called insight builder. So that is feature number 3. The last one is the ability to send and schedule a report. So previously we could download a CSV and PDF, but now we added support for scheduling a report to be delivered. So if you come up to the share menu and click on schedule export, you'll get this send modal where you can customize the delivery of what you're wanting. So you can choose the file type, give it a description, add recipients to it, and then you can choose your send frequency. So you can do weekly, monthly, yearly sends, the day you want it to start and end, how many times a week you want to send it, and which day you want it sent on. And so once you have that set up, I want to do a PDF of this. I'm going to click send on schedule, and now it's been successfully created. Now, for every organization, you can only do send 10 schedules. So if you notice before, under schedule export, you have a manager. So if I click on manage schedules, I can see the two that I've created. And so now I can see my organization has 2 reports out of 10. So once I get to that 10 limit, I won't be able to schedule anymore until I delete or disable any of the previous schedules that I've already sent or they expire. That's something to keep in mind as you're dealing with your schedules. But now you can use this to send out your reports on a schedule to your user base and stakeholders to make sure they're informed if they may not be coming to the product. This has been a long time request for AJO users, and so now we've got support for scheduling and then managing those schedules as well. So that is feature number 4. So these are some great new capabilities we've added to the reporting experience within Journey Optimizer. Thank you for your time.